Stay tuned, because in a second, I'm going to show you how to crush your Punta Cana trip in 5 simple steps. And while you're here, while I have your attention, go ahead and hit the like and subscribe button for more videos like this. Step number one, make sure that you have an idea of where your villa or hotel is and ask to see the list. All the prices are preset and try not to get ripped off. If you take a look at it and it doesn't look right, go to the next taxi. I called a friend. I'm going to leave his number in the description, so if you need to use him, feel free to call him. He's like the unofficial Uber. You come to Punta Cana. If you don't want to go to have a regular taxi and they charge way too much money and very expensive, you can call like a friend, you know, an amigo, and they'll come pick you up from the airport. So here I have my boy.
Como te llamas?
Juan Luis.
Luis,
Juan,
my boy Luis.
Guerra.
Yeah. Right? Yeah. So my boy come pick you up from the airport like a friend, you know, he tell you information about the town, where to go, what to sightsee, about the clubs, and whatever you need to know. So sometimes it's better to have somebody that's not a taxi come get you, because it's like an Uber. That's why a lot of people use Uber. So it's like Uber. Uber Dominicano. Yeah? So I'm going to put his number in the bottom right there so you can see it. Or I'll flash it on the screen. And if you come to, if you come to Punta Cana, give this guy a call. He's dependable. He's on time. And the best thing about it, he used propane. So it's better for the environment. Step number two. If you're staying in a villa or all-inclusive resort, don't be scared to leave the villa or the resort. Get out there, mingle with the locals, go try the local food, get out and explore. The people there are very friendly, very warm, very helpful, but just like any place you go to outside or even in US, use caution and be careful. Now let's talk about the food here. Let's talk about the food. So, the food here is absolutely delicious. They have square burritos. It's still a burrito, even though it's square. They've had mofongo, which I didn't get a chance to try there. But fish, rice, beans, plantains, mofongo, fried chicken, baked chicken. You can't go wrong with Dominican food. I grew up around it, originally from Brooklyn, New York. So, I was very familiar with it, felt right at home. Try the local food. The food at the resort is probably good, but you gotta get out and try the local food. Gotta. Time to talk about the drinks. You can't go wrong just going to any hole-in-the-wall bar, any bar, anywhere, and the drinks will be phenomenal. Also, the Dominican rum. Ooh-wee. Oh my gosh. This one right here is off the chain. It's so strong, so good, and so smooth. It will put some hair on your chest, and if you have some on it, it'll put more hair in your chest. One of my favorite things to drink while I'm in the Caribbeans, in the DR, is Presidente. Hands down, it's always been one of my favorite beers. However, for some reason, I kept getting the Presidente Light. I'm like, why do they keep giving me Presidente Light? I like Presidente, and I guess I like Presidente Light, but I like the Presidente Regular even better. However, let's talk about the beer of Punta Cana. Oh my gosh, this stuff is out of control. Oh, Punta Cana. It's so good.
So let's get this cigar removed. Boom. Okay, the cigar is removed. Just gonna give this beer a shot. Let's see what we think about it. Tell you what my opinion is on it. If you should even bother wasting your time having one of these when you come to Punta Cana. Oh, that's good. This is good beer. Highly recommend it. When you come to Punta Cana, you gotta try it. It's so good. Oh, hold up. Oh, I like that beer. Here's the name of it. You come to Punta Cana, if you don't rack up on a dozen of these, something's wrong with you.
Step number three. Go ahead and go clubbing with the locals. Go salsa, go bachata, go merengue. with the locals. There are tons and tons of fun, and the drinks are super, super cheap compared to US. They are off the chain. And guys, let me tell you, they have hookah and all the amenities that you expect in a US club. You gotta get out and go party with the locals. Just get out and go do it. Don't worry about it. It's safe, they have security, everything's all good. Go have fun and turn up. Step number four. We're all the way at four. Is it four or five? Yeah, I think we're at four. Alright, so step number four. Make sure before you leave, you spend some time at the beach. And I mean some nice, relaxing, enjoyable time at the beach. The beaches are absolutely beautiful out there. The water's clean, the beach is clean. You can bring bottles there because, well, soap and container is no problem out there in Dominican Republic. It's not like U.S. But go out there and have fun. And if you're into it, I don't think they have jet skis because they didn't have any where we were. But you can do, you know, like the skiing and a bunch of other activities. Banana boats, and they got a pirate ship out there. Tons of things to do at the beach. Go to the beach, enjoy yourself, and hang out. After the beach, it's time to go shopping. Go check out one of the malls. I believe they have like three malls in Punta Cana area. The malls are absolutely nice. A lot of places to get the last minute souvenirs. And don't forget to get some more fried chicken before you leave. Their fried chicken is absolutely delicious. I enjoyed my trip to Punta Cana. I give, I would say 10 out of 10. It was fun. It was enjoyable. The food was good. The drinks were good. And I enjoyed myself. If you guys have any questions about Dominican Republic, leave a comment below. Like and subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. More tips and tricks on the destinations that are hot. And places you might be going. Like and subscribe. This is Kev Mystico. Get it. I'm out. Peace.